Mike and Daniel are working on a technological tweak that will boost the flavor profile of their moonshine.
Hello.
Come on in.
What the hell you welding on, son?
Well, I'm building us a burner. I figure we might need another.
That's right. There's old pretty girl, ain't it?
Yeah.
Me and Daniel, we actually built this little silver cloud last year out of old beer kegs. It's just an all-around good rig to make brandies out of. I like to do a little modification to it to infuse flavors. If we could build an arm from here to the worm, I've got a couple of jars here. Create two gin baskets to pack fruit in them and let the steam come over and infuse into them gin baskets. And I believe it'll hit that flavor note just right. Having this debt with Martin Digger has really motivated me and Daniel to get out there and do some creative things. All this flavored stuff yields a higher price per gallon, so we can make bigger money for less volume of alcohol. That way we can put a little money in our pocket, pay our debt off, and go on about our business.
While the origins of gin date back to the Middle Ages, the use of gin baskets is a more recent development for infusing grain spirits with botanicals like juniper. Traditionally, a gin basket is a porous stainless steel container affixed inside the pot. But Mike and Daniel's gin baskets are a set of mason jars attached along the arms that connect the thump keg to the condenser. As alcohol vapor leaves the thump keg, it passes through the gin baskets. There, the flavors of any added fruit are infused into the vapor before it's turned back into liquid by the condenser.
Holy damn.
I thought you was gonna hold it.
Well, I am holding it. No wonder why your old lady don't want to have nothing to do with you. You try to drive too hard all the time.
I drive too fast, don't I?
That nerd needs to go in just to fuzz her. So I've rigged these gin baskets up as if you would a thump keg. The very first arm goes all the way to the bottom of the jar where nothing can feed back, because that pipe's blowing out and your second pipe's pulling up. So we only drop the second pipe that far down in the jar, and your fruit's down here bubbling, and just your steam and flavor from those fruits goes up through that other arm.
That looks good to me.
Good enough for government work. Voila.
Each time it runs through one of those jars, not only is it infused in flavor, it's actually double distilling every time it runs through. So on a regular run, you'd probably get 7 or 8 gallons of liquor. In this case, I'll probably get 10 to 12. This is gonna make a big difference in the moonshine world. This is gonna be high quality liquor. I say she's ready for the woods, man.
Watch that slick ass bank.
It's slick, ain't it, buddy?
In the Great Smoky Mountains, Mike and Daniel are embarking on their maiden run of the season.
Let's check that mash out.
Good God. It's loud. Is it about ready to go?
No, it is ready to go. You can taste the mangoes in it, too.
Mm-hmm. It's strong, for sure.
Let's get this stuff set up so we can fire it up. We've got to dig out flat pads up the side of the mountain to where it'll all set level. I want you to look at that. That goes plumb to China. Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
That's where the old-timers used to do it 100 years ago. They purposely picked the hardest spot to dig out, to carve into, just so somebody just won't stumble up on their side.
You know, it don't even matter. We'll dig it right now, or we'll dig it when they catch us running liquor. We'll be on the chain gang busting rock.
Well, sure enough, have you on there, boy. You good at that, ain't you?
Well, this moonshine's easy, ain't it?
Easiest thing in the world. What's wrong with that right there?
I don't see nothing, except it ain't got alcohol coming out of it yet.
Our base mash was mangoes. That goes into our pot. Now all we gotta do is fire it up and see how it goes.
I'm ready when you are, buddy.
Put it to it.
That'll work.
We got that fire lit for the first time this season. It's like the gun going off at the first race. Bam, baby, I'm ready to go. I believe that right there will make some good stuff, buddy. This will be the first time we ever tested out these gin baskets. It was just an idea that I come up with to transfer flavors. My biggest hope is that mango mash infuses into that pineapple and kiwi, you know, and creates that good brandy.
Just work it around as you go down.
That right there, Art, the transfer. I'm gonna put the old coon rod in here and get her ready.
Lay it to it.
All righty.
We actually start to transfer into the first jar and the second one just a little. And from here out, you'll have mango, pineapple, kiwi flavor coming all the way down and out to the worm. It's actually gonna be distilled four separate times before it ever comes out the worm. And each time it distills, it's getting more and more pure as it goes down the line.
I'm liking it. We got liquor running too.
Oh, Lord, we do, don't we? Boy, damn, you can taste the fruit in it. It's hot. I'm gonna pitch them heads off real quick. Let's take his horn out. God almighty, that's good, son. I can taste a pineapple coming through hard on it.
And on the first.
And it's number one. Damn, it tastes just like I thought it would. You can taste that mango right off the top, and behind that, you can taste a hint of the pineapple and a hint of the kiwi. Looks like we about got a bucket full of liquor over there, don't we? Let's pop this cap. Let's get up here and get our jars. It turned out to be 6 good gallons of 120 proof brandy. It tastes great. I love it, and I believe it'll fetch a high dollar. My God, that's some pretty brandy.